So, yes, we have got.
Right.
Welcome all. Today is the. We have our guest, Dr. V. L. Kumaraswamy, MA PhD. He is a student. He happens to be my senior in my school, in my college. So he studied at the Yahogalamat Oriental High School. Then it was high school. Now it has become higher secondary school. He continued with Vivekananda College for his BA and MA. And he worked at the same school of study for a year. And he was studying at the evening classes of Mambalam Samskita Vidyalaya under the eminent scholar Uve Olpakkam Rajagopalacharyar. So he was handling classes also there in the evening college, evening classes, sir. And he has passed all the Chittoor examinations also. From there, from Yahogalamat Oriental School, working after 1 year at Yahogalamat Oriental School, he moved to Sri Venkatramana Ayurveda Vaidyashala. And he worked there for more than 10 years, nearly 10 years, under the famous doctor, Sri Vishwanatha Sarma. And he continued his service for 30 years. He says 5 years only he worked there. And he worked nearly for three decades at the D.G. Vaishnav College, where from he retired as the associate professor of Sanskrit. And he is a famous Sanskritist in the field. He has taken classes at different places. And he was a pet for his teachers and also for his students. During his studies, a trio was there, excepting one person. All of them are present here. Dr. K. Srinivasan, he was formerly the principal of Ramakrishna Mission Vivekananda College. We have him on in our audience, and he will be addressing us some date in future date. And number two is Dr. Balasubramanian, curator and epigraphist. He retired as the epigraphist and curator at Government Museum, Egmore, Chennai. And third one is Dr. L. Kumaraswamy. It was a trio. I happened to be their junior by 3 years. He did research in Arthantaranyasa Alankara for his PhD. He is also a Sahitya Shiromani. He has been taking online classes on all these COVID years. His favorites, Ramayanam, Srimad Bhagavatam, Vishnu Puranam, and Raghuvamsham. He still continues to take classes. And he was gracious enough to cancel one of his classes to be with us. He is also taking classes for the dance students of Kalakshetra Adyar Chennai. Now, in this session, Dr. L. Kumaraswamy will speak on Vari Varga in Amarakosha. This being the Amarakosha study circle, sir, Dr. Kumaraswamy. We have participants from various walks of life. From throughout the world, we have participants from US, we have participants from Europe, we have participants from Australia, and different parts of India, Karnataka, Kerala, Andhra Pradesh, Rajasthan, and all those places. Nearly we have got 108 participants. And today, right now, we have 28 participants right now, including the new guests. And this is being sponsored by our management, National College Management. And this is run by Dr. V. Krishnamurthy, famously called the BHUL Krishnamurthy. And our secretary is Dr. Raghu, Professor, sorry. He is Mr. Raghunathan. He is a famous lawyer, advocate. And this project is sponsored by Sri N.L. Raja, belonging to the Nangavaram family. It is being run under the name of Sri N.D. Lakshmi Narayana Iyer Trust. So, we have the management totally supports this project, and it is through them that we are able to do this. And thanks to our management, thanks to the staff who are behind this this endeavor. We have our webmaster, we have our staff members who are just watching this and then recording this. And thanks to all those. We have people who prepare the flyer for this, and there is a team of 10 people working behind this when we come on the street. So thanks to all of them. Over to Dr. L. Kumaraswamy, who will speak on Vari Varga in our question. Dr. Kumaraswamy.
Okay, thank you. Apara Karuna Sindham Jnanadam Santarupinam Shri Chandra Shekhara Gurum Pranamami Udantaham Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam Gurur Brahma Gurur Vishnu Gurur Devo Maheshwara Guru Sakshat Param Brahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Chatur Mukha Mukham Bhojavanaham Savadhur Mama Manase Ramadam Nityam Sarva Shukla Saraswati. Yasya Jnana Daya Sindho Raga Dhasya Nagha Guna Sevyatam Akshayo Dhiraha Sashriyai Cha Amritaya Cha. So this is the Mangala Shloka of Namalinga Anushasanam or Amarakosha, as it is called. We all know pretty well that this is not the first session in Amarakosha. So Amarakosha deals with a lexicon or a kind of a dictionary where you have synonyms, and also there is another part of this particular Amarakosha. So there you have a kind of where you a single word, how it is used in Sanskrit literature. So that is also there in the second kanda and the third kanda. As far as the first kanda of this Amarakosha is concerned, consists of 12 chapters. All of them deal with only the synonyms. And now I have taken up the Vari Varga. Vari Varga is the last one of this kanda. And I hope you are all familiar with the rules and regulations of this particular book, Amarakosha, where how you should go about looking for a word, and how it should be read, what are all the different nyayas that govern this work and all that. So as we proceed with that, we will deal with them also, because there are some students of mine who joined there. And for them, I think it will be a new one. I have talked about Amarakosha in my classes, but I have not taken it as a class. I did take it some 10 years ago for a set of students. But later on, as I could not continue the class because of lack of time and place. Okay, so this is Vari Varga. Vari, you all know that Vari means it deals with water. So it is not only dealing with water, it deals with the things that are connected with water. That is the beauty of this chapter. We know that I am going to talk about only the synonyms of jalam, salilam, tirtham, vari, and all that, people will definitely be bored for hearing all these things. But here, Amara begins with the ocean. Samudrobdhi akupara paravara saritpati udanvan mudadhisindhu saraswan sagaror nava ratnakaro jalanidhi yadapati apampati. This is how he begins. and I do not know whether I will be able to complete the portion within an hour, but I will do my best. And some of these words which are very popular, I don't have to tell you the meaning. Samudraha, it's about the sea. Abdhihi. And in my preparation of this talk, I took the help of as they come and get collected in one place. That is called Samudra. Okay. And then Akuparaha. So Akuparaha, it is again, it deals with, it means sea. So you will have to say, you will have to find out what is Kuparaha. So Kuparaha means Param Avrunoti or Uscha Uscha Kvav Piparti. That is, this is something, a kind of a place where the water gets filled. That is called Paraha. Ku is the Prithvi. So Ku Paraha means that is the place where all the excess water, they get collected. And Apuparaha, then how, why it is A is added there? The A is added because it does not require any kupa. There is no kupa here. There is kupa is the one where water is collected. But here it is not a well. So therefore, Akuparaha, Paravaraha. Paravara is where the payorasi is collected within two banks. So that is called Paravara. Saripati is a very well known thing. There is a lot of rivers. Udanvan, Udadhi, Sindhu, these are all very familiar things. Saraswan, Sagaraha. And Sagara is, you know pretty well, this is a story from Ramayana, Sagara, Ikshvaku Vamsha, Raja, Arnavaha. Ratnakaraha means it's a mine of gems. So especially the pearls are found only in the Samudra, and pearls are one of the gems. So therefore, it is called Ratnakaraha. Jalanidhi, so it's a treasure of water. Yadavpatihi means this is the lord of all sea animals. So that is why Yadaha means the jantus which live in sea is called Yadaha. Therefore, Yadaha, Yadavpatihi, Apampatihi, he is the lord of waters. And then Tasya Prabheraha, he goes next. Tasya prabheraha kshirodo lavanodas tathapare. If you take up, we know only the salty sea. But in the Agamas, we come to know about seven different seas. So they are kshirodaha, lavanodaha, dadhyudaha, dhrutodaha, surodaha, Ikshudaha, Swadudaha. So if you take any Agama for that matter, I had the chance of going through Suprabheda Agama, and there they are discussing about all these different seas. That is before the final place of Shiva is found. It is the Brahmanda. It is surrounded by all these seas. So the first one, Kshiroda, is known to us, where Lord Narayana is resting. Kshiroda is the milky ocean. Lavanoda is the salty ocean. And then Dadhyudaha is the ocean consisting of Dadhi, and then we have Ghrutodaha, the C consisting of Ghritam, Ghi, and then Surodaha. Sura means it is a liquor. So another C consisting of liquor, Surodaha. And then Ikshudaha, another C consisting of the Ikshurasa. The Ikshurasa. And the Swadudaha, again another C is there, which is full of good water. Swadudaha, which is full of good water. Okay, so this is with reference to the Samudra. Now he talks about the water itself. Apastri bhumnivar vari salilam kamalam jalam payahkilalam amrutam jivanam bhuvanam vanam kabandhamudakam pathah pushkaram sarvatomukham ambhornastoyapaniye nirakshirambushambaram megha pushpam ghanarasa. Up to then it goes. Apaha, this is a word you all know pretty well, that it belongs to Strilinga and it is always used in Bahuvachanam. And then Bhumni, in the Bhumi, we have these words, Var, Vari, Salilam, Kamalam, Jalam. Var is Repanta Napumsakalinga Shabda. Vahavari, Vari, Vahavari, Vari. Vara, Varbhyam, Varbhi, the Shabda goes like that. And then we have Vari, Vari is known, it's Ikaranta Napumsakalinga Shabda, Vari, Varini, Varini, Vari, Varini, Varini, like that. Salilam, Kamalam is, Salilam is a very popular word, but Kamalam is a new word. The word Kamala, it has, it is found in three genders, in all the three genders. We know only Kamalam, Kamale, Kamalan. But Kamalam, Kamala, you know pretty well. Kamala means Shri. That is, it refers to Lakshmi. Kamalaha, it's a kind of animal. Kamalaha, Mrigantare. And then Kamalam is used for Jalam. Jalam and Padmam. Kamala Shrihi Jalam Padmam Kamalam Kamalo Mrigaha. So this is how it is said. So Kamalam, when used in the Napumsakalinga, it refers to both a lotus flower as well as water. And then the other Kamalaha means, if it is used in Pullinga, it refers to an animal. So which animal, it has not been given here. And Kamala is very well known. Kamala refers to another name of goddess Lakshmi. Jalam is very well known to us. And then we have Payaha. The word Payaha, Kshirecha Neerecha. So it refers to both the milk as well as water. And then Keelalam. Keelalam also Rudhire Toye. So it has a connotation of both blood as well as water. And then we have Amrutam. Amrutam means what? Amrutam yajnaseshe syat piyushe salile grite ayachite cha mokshe cha na dhanvantari devayoho. So Amrutam, the literal meaning is na amrutam maranam asti asmin. So there is no death in that. But here, in Yajnasesha, it is called Amritam. Yajnasesha, it is called Amritam. Yajnasesha Amrita Bhujaha. That's what Bhagavan says in Bhagavad Gita. Yajnasesha Amrita Bhujaha. So Amritam is Yajnasesha. And then it refers to Piyusha. Piyusha is Nectar, Salilam, Dhritam. It has the meaning of water as well as ghee. And then Jeevanam. Jeevanam is, you know, that life. So life factor is a important. So Neera Prana Dharana Yoho. So Jeevanam Vartate Neera Prana Dharana Yoho. So without Jeevanam, there is no life on earth. Okay. And then we have Bhuvanam. Bhuvanam is a word normally not used for water, but rarely it is used. And Vishtape api syat salile gagane jale. So it refers to salilam also, gagane jale. And then vanam. Vanam is also used for water. Vanam means vanyate sambhajyate sevyate va. So something which is stored. So that is why it is called vanam. Okay. And then in I hope jivanam bhuvanam visham is also one of the words. Instead of vanam, we have visham in some books. Visham is also, besides referring to poison, it also refers to water. Because if Ananta Narayanan remembers well, we had a small skit in our school as Vishapanam, written by Venkatrakabacharya, and our friend Srinivasan also acted in that, I believe. So Visham is also meaning water, but it is not found in the book. Okay, the next word is called Kabandham. Kabandham, you all know. Kabandham means the headless trunk is called Kabandha. That is the normal meaning attached to that. But Kabandho stri, kriyajuktam apamurdha kalebare, klibam jale. So if it is used in Pullinga, it refers to the headless trunk. If it is used as Napumsakalinga, it refers to water. So you can find the differences here and there. And then Udakam, Pathaha. Pathaha is Sakaranta Napumsakalinga Shabda. It's not Akarantam. It may look like Akaranta. Pathaha Pathasi, Pathamsi. Pathaha Pathasi, Pathamsi. It goes like that. And then Pushkaram. Pushkaram, normally it may refers to a lotus pond, but it also refers to water. And then Sarvatomukham. The Sarvatomukha, if it is in Pullinga, it refers to Kshetrajna Brahmanoho Puman. So Kshetrajna and Brahman, it refers to, in Pullinga, if it is used in Pullinga, it will refer to the Kshetrajna and Brahman. But Napumsakam tu Paniye. If it is used in Napumsakalinga, it refers to water. So, Ambhav Pushkaram Sarvatomukham Ambhavarna Stoya Paniya Neerakshira Ambu Shambaram. So, all these words, Stoya, Paniya, Neeram, Kshiram, these are all very popular words where I don't have to explain how they are called. And then Shambaram. Shambaram is in Napumsakalinga, it refers to Salila. Pumsi Mriga Daitya Visheshayoho. And when it is used, Shambaraha in Pullinga, it refers to an animal, or it refers to even a Rakshasa called the Shambarasura. And then Megha Pushpam Ghanarasaha. Megha Pushpam Ghanarasaha. So Megha Pushpam means it's almost it's a kind of a beautiful description. Because it comes from the sky, from the cloud. Hence it is called, described as Megha Pushpa and Ghanarasa. Ghanarasa is the juice of the clouds. So these are all the beautiful words that we get of water. And then Trishu Dve Aapyam Ammayam. Trishu Dve Aapyam Ammayam. Trishu here means what? When word Trishu is used in Amar Kosha, you will have to understand that this word has to be taken in all the three genders. So, but there are only two words, Trishu Dve, Aapyam and Ammayam. And Aapyam and Ammayam means Apam Vikara. Apam vikara, it does not refer to water, but it refers to some change, some formation of water. So we have apyam means something made of water. Ammayam means also something made of water. So we have four different bodies. We have Parthiva Sharira, we have Jaliya Sharira, we have Taijasiya Sharira, and we have Vayaviya Sharira. We don't have the Panchabhutas, the last one. Akashiya Sharira, we don't have. But for all the other four bhutas, the Shariras are there. I mean, what Sharira that we now have is called the Parthiva Sharira. And the Apsarasris, they are all having the Jaliya Sharira. If you look into all these things, everything, it has all these Shariras have kind of Uttama, Madhyama, Adhama Shariras in all these things. Now, I don't want to get into that. But I'm just giving you the information for all these things. And then, so there is apyam and the ammayam. And then, bhangas taranga. And then next is the samudra. We have the waves. So he talks about the waves. Bhangas taranga urmirva. Kriyam Vichihi. So Bhanga, Taranga, Urmihi. So these are all Pullinga words. And Urmi is, Vichi is the one which is a Strilinga word. So all these things refer to the waves of the ocean or waves of the, a very big, if you have a very big water. Storage point, you will have waves there also. Okay, reservoir or a big pond, you will have all these things. Okay, then let me go to the next point. And there in the waves, he talks about if the waves are small, you will have to use the bhanga, taranga and all that. If the waves are very big, when you go to the beach, you will find the waves coming. And during tsunami, the waves will be very high. So, mahatsu ullola kallolau. So, if the waves are very big, then the words used are the two words, ullola and kallola. These are the words. And then, we have the next term. Syadavarto ambhasam ramaha. There is a word called avartaha. Avartaha means whirlpool. That is called, what in Tamil we say, suri. So that is called avartaha. Syadavartaha ambhasam ramaha. He explains that. Ambhasam ramaha means there is a circular motion inside the water. So that is called avarta, whirlpool. Jalanam brahmanasya ekam. Prishanti bindu prishataha umamso vipurushastriyaha. The next one is about the drop and the droplets of water. So here, prishanti bindu prishataha umamsaha vipurushaha striyaha. So here, if you see that Prishat Shabda is a Napumsakalinga Shabda. That's why he has specifically stated Prishanti, Prishat, Prishati, Prishanti. That is the Shabda there. And then Bindu Prishataha. So these two words are Kumamsaha. Prishat, Prishato, Prishataha. That is also there in Pullinga. Bindu, Bindu, Bindava, that's Ukaranta, Pullinga Shabda. And then Viprut Shabda is a Strilinga Shabda. Viprut, Viprusha, Viprushaha. That way it has to be understood. All these things, especially Bindu, you know pretty well. Bindu is a small drop of water. Prushat means it's a big drop. You know that Varsham means it's rain. You know, asaraha, there is a word. I don't know if it finds place here. Asaraha means that it's a drizzle. A very thick drizzle is called asaraha in Sanskrit. So, in the same manner, a small drop is called bindu. Prushat is a big drop. Okay, so very thick drop is called a prushat. And then viprut is also a small drop. And then vakrani putabheda syu. And he uses the word vakrani or chakrani. Chakrani or vakrani. Putabheda syu. Putabhedaha means it's a different type of whirlpools, where it's called a chakram or putabheda, etc. And then we go to the next one. Brahmascha jala nirgamaha. Putabhedaha bhedastu nagara nagarataha nagara ato yayoho. Tatini mukhe haimaha, the haima lexicon, it says a different meaning there. So chakrakarena jalanam adhoyanasya. That is, so when you bring water from upwards to downwards, so that is called the putabheda, they say. And it comes in the form of a wheel like whirlpool like way it is brought down. And then brahmascha jala nirgamaha. Brahmascha jala nirgamaha. Brahma jala nirgama. So from a very bigger water source, you just bring it to a smaller portion. Small, just like later on we will have kulya. Kritrima sarit. Kulya means it's a very small canal. So the through which the water is let in. So that is called the jalanirgamaha. And then we have next to kulam rodhascha tiram cha pratiram cha takam trishu. So kulam rodhascha tiram cha pratiram cha. Up to that every word is an Napumsakalinga Shabda. And then, you know, all these words mean only the bank of a river, bank of a pond, and all that. And then Tatam is Trishu. Tataha, Tati, Tatam. So it has to be understood in the three lingas. And then Paravare, Pararuvachi, Tire. So Paravare, Paraha, Avaraha, Para, Aruachi. What is Paraha and Avaraha and the Paraha and Aruachi? Here, this rather bank is called Paraha. Aruachi is the opposite bank. In the same manner, Paraha is this bank and Avaraha is the other bank. Avaraha. Avaraha is the opposite bank. That's how it is to be understood. And then the next very beautiful word is patram. Patram is paravarayoho antaram madhyam. So it's a kind of a middle way of the two banks. That is called patram. Patram tu kulayoho madhye. So that is called tatamadhyavarti pravahasya patram iti abhidhiyate. That is but you know pretty well patram has several other meanings also. Patram means a vessel, and patram refers to a satpatram and all that. And patram means that is in the drama, you have the patram, the roles. That is also called the patram. So these are all the different meanings of patram. And then the other thing which is attached to vari is dvipostriyam antaripam yadantar varinas tatam. Dvipaha, you know pretty well, it's an island. Antaripaha also means island. And astriyam, wherever you have the word astriyam. Astriyam means what? It has no strilinga shabda. Dvipa cannot be used in strilinga. But when it is, you say that, when it is said that it is cannot be used in strilinga, that means it can be used both in pullinga and napumsakalinga. So that's how it has to be understood. So dvipaha or dvipam. And then yadantar varinaha tatam. So it is antarvarina. It is within the water. It is surrounded by water. Jalamadhyastha sthanasya toyotthitam. And then next one is toyotthitam tat pulinam. So there are two beautiful words in Sanskrit. One is pulinam. The other word is saikatam. So that is the next word is saikatam sikatamayam. Pulinam is a grassy meadow, is called the pulinam. In several of the Bhasa's dramas, we have seen the word used, being used, pulinam. So toyotthitam means after you come up out of the toya, the water, you get into the grassy meadow. That is called the pulinam. Saikatam is a sandy region, sikatam. And then valuka, valuka is another word used for sand in Sanskrit. And then, now he goes to the Nishadvarastu Jambalaha Pankostri Shadakardamau. So he goes to a place where water and the panka, panka is mire, where water and the earth, they are together. And in Tamil, we call it as Sher Mire, M-I-R-E, Mire. So there we have Nishadvaraha, Jambalaha. Pankaha is a very popular term for that thing. Because from that we have the word Pankajam, Pankatri Jayatri Pankajam. And as I told you, Astri. So Pankaha, Astri. Astri means what? It is not used in Srilinga. That means it can be Panka, the word can be used both in Pullinga and Napumsakalinga, but not with reference to Nishadvara and Jambala, because Amara has been very intelligent in pointing them out, singling them out, and using them only in Pullinga. And then Shada Kardama, again, these are all the Pullinga Shabda, Shada and Kardama. Kardama is a word where you have the water mixed with so much of the earth. So that is why when the water is running, the running water, you don't find the kardama. In Valmiki Ramayana, when Valmiki goes to take a dip in the Tamasa River, he asks his student, Bharadwaja, hey Bharadwaja, Nishamaya, hey Bharra, you look into this. So here this water of Tamasa River, Akardamam Prasannambu Sanmanushya Manoyatha. There, Valmiki is a father of Kalidasa, especially in beautifully bringing out the similes. So he says, this water is so clear without any kind of dust, and then it is prasanna, it is so pleasing, it is so clear, crystal clear, that is called the prasanna. Akardamam, it has nothing to do with any dust, so that is why it is so clear. And he says, how it is clear, it is so clear, crystal clear, like the mind of a great man. Sanmanushya manoyata. So that's the beauty. Okay, and then he goes to talk about the canals. He says, Jalochvasaha parivaha. So these are all the two words, jaloshvasaha and parivahaha, talking about the canal. Kupakastu vidarakaha. And then, you know, there when we dig well, we will be waiting for some of the springs to come out. That spring that you see in a well is called the kupakaha. The spring that you see in a mountainous region where there you find a small cleavage between rocks, that is called vidarakaha. So kupakastu vidarakaha. So these two things, they talk about the springs. Okay. And then navyam trilingam nautarye. So navyam is a trilingam. It can be used in all the three lingas. Navyam means what? Navatarium. That is, this is a distance which can be covered through a boat. Or this is a place where it has to be crossed only by means of boat. There is no other transport available here. That is the meaning here. Nautarium and Navatarium. All that. And then, Striyam Naustarani Starihi. And in Striyam, Strilinga, we have Nauhu, Taranihi, Tarihi. All these things refer to small boats. Okay. And then, Udupam Tu Plavah Kolaha. And then this Udupa. Udupa is a word and everyone must be aware of this word because Kalidasa has used it in his Raghuvamsha. Kusurya Prabhavo Vamshaha Uchalpa Vishayamatihi. Titirshu Dustaram Mohatu Udupe Nasmi Sagaram. So Udupa there, Malinata says Udupa is a very small boat which has made of even animal hide, he says. And then Plavaha, again a small boat, Kolaha. And Udupa is also said as what we have a small a circular barrage, something like that. In Tamil, it is called the Parisal. That is also called Udupa. Plavaha and Kolaha means, you know, in temples, we perform Tepotsavam. In Tepotsavam, we build Plavaha because they actually float on the water. That is called the Plavaha and the Kolaha. Okay, barges. That is called Plavaha and the Kolaha. And then the next thing is Udupamtu Plavah Kolaha. Srotombu Saranam Swataha. Srotaha. Srotaha is a very small stream, is called Ambu Saranam. That is called Srotaha. And then Ataraha Tarapanyam Syat. Ataraha is the charge, the money that we give for crossing the river, that is called Ataraha. Kuli, Padagu Kuli, Ataraha, Tarapanyam. You know the word Panyam. From that we have the Tamil word Panam. Panaha, Panaha means money. Panyam actually refers to the wares, the things which can be obtained through Panam. So Tarapanyam is, it is the money is charged for crossing a service. We have service charges nowadays. That can be called as the service for the boat service, Tarapanyam. The charges for boat service is Tarapanyam. Okay. And then we have Droni Kashtambu Vahini. Droni Kashtambu Vahini. Droni is a small, we can say a small wooden plank, catching hold of it so one can swim across a river. So that is why Kashta Ambuvahini. So you can cross, float in the water by catching hold on to that Kashta. Okay, and then Sanyatrikaha Potavanik. Sanyatrikaha Potavanik. So both the words refer to the traders who go to the other countries by using the ships or boats. So that is why it refers to Sanyatrikaha. That is people who go to the other shores, other countries by means of boat, by crossing the ocean. Vahitra Gamino Vanijaha. That's what he says. Vahitram, another word. It refers to a big boat or a ship. And then Karanadharastu Navikaha. Now these two words refer to sailors. Karanadharaha and Navikaha. Very, very popular words. Kupako Gunavrikshakaha. Kupakaha. And then I think I have left out one. Niyamakaha Potavahaha. Niyamakaha and Potavahaha means the people who stay in the boat and they actually drive the boat. Okay, especially having a lot of things to transport from one end to another. So they carry goods. So that they are called Niyamakaha and Potavahaha. That is, they have the boats only for carrying goods. So that is called Potavahaha. And then Kupako Gunavrikshakaha. Kupakaha Gunavrikshakaha means we have, you know, some boats have the sail. The mast of the sail is called Kupakaha and Gunavrikshakaha. The mast of the sail. That is called Kupakaha and Gunavrikshakaha. Nauka Dandaha Kshepani Syat. Kshepani is a very popular term. Kshepani means oar with which you drive the boat. And it will be there. Nauka Dandaha is there on both sides. And especially in some of these yesteryear cinemas, you will find when there is a boat sequence, the sailors will be we have a very tough time by taking the boat with their oars. So kshepani. So nauka parshvadvaja baddha chalana kashtasya. And then aritram keni patakaha. Aritram keni patakaha. This aritra is nau prishtastha chalana kashtasya. At one end of the boat, there will be a small kashta, a wood, with which the sailor will be turning the boat. So that is that is called aritram, or aritram or kashta kuddala. And then seka patram to sechanam. Sometimes when you have the water getting collected inside the boat, so that has to be built out. You need to have a vessel for that. So that is called seka patram to sechanam. And then klibe ardhanavam navurdhe. If it is a small boat, almost built the size of a bigger ship, so that is called ardhanavam. And then atita nauke atinu. Atita naukaha means the water is coming beyond the level of a nauka, a boat, or a ship is called atita naukaha and atinu. And then we have Trishvagadhat Prasannochaha. So this Prasannaha and Achaha, this word Prasanna I have already quoted from Ramayana. So again, these two words have to be taken in three genders. Prasannaha Achaha means very crystal clear. And especially after the rain is over, during this Sharad season, you know pretty well that things will get clear. All the mire will get settled down, down under, and on the top of it you will have the Prasannambu. Okay, and then Achaha, and then the opposite of it is Kalushaha, Anachaha, Avilaha. So Kalushaha, Anachaha, Avilaha. All these things are a bit muddy. A muddy water is called Avilaha. Kalushaha, Anachaha. And then Nimnam, Gabhiram, Gambhiram. So these three words, Nimnam, Gabhiram, and Gambhiram, they talk about the depth of the river or pond or a water source. So that is called, that is why the river is called the Nimnaga, because it goes down from the top to the bottom. So Nimnam, Gabhiram, Gambhiram, all that. And we have Uttanam Tadviparye. So if it is a place where it is a higher place from the lower to the higher. So that is called Uttanam. Agadham Atalasparishe. So Agadham is very, very deep. Atalasparisha, almost touching the ground of the water or even the sea, sea ground. And then we have the words like Kaivarte Dasha Dhivarav. Kaivarte Dasha Dhivarav. So these are all the words for fishermen. Kaivartaha, Dasaha, Dhivaraha. These are all, they all refer to the fishermen. And then, what do the fishermen carry? So they carry a net. So Anayaha Kumsi Jalam Siyan. Anayaha is Pullinga. Jalam is an Apumsakalinga Shabda. So both of them talk about the net that the fishermen carry to catch fish. And then Shana Sutram Pravitrakam. So again here, Shana Sutram Pravitrakam is a kind of an instrument with which they used to catch fish. That is, one is made of Shana Sutra and the other one is made of Pavitraka, a kind of a grass. Okay. Because later on we have a word, Badisham and Matsavedhanam. Badisham and Matsavedhanam, it refers to the hook. But these hooks are made of iron. Whereas this Shana Sutram and Pavitrakam, they are, Shana is, you know, pretty well, we have the Shanal, Shanal Kairi, we say in Tamil. And then we have Pavitrakam is made of grass. So they have, in those days, they had that kind of a, that is, Pavitrakam means it will be like a Pavitram that we wear on our hand, but with which they used to catch fish. And then Matsyadhani Kuveni Sya. This Matsyadhani and Kuveni, these two words, Srilinga Shabda, they refer to a kind of a very big basket to collect the fish. So that is the Matsyadhani and the Kuveni. Badisham and Matsyavedhanam, I have already told you, they both the words refer to the hook, the iron hook. And then he gives a long list of the different kinds of fish that you see. Pruthuroma, Jasho, Matsyo, Meeno, Vaisari, Nondajaha, Visara, Shakali, Chatha, Sahasrad, Gadakaha, Shakalardhakaha, Sahasradamshtraha, Patinaha, Ulupi, Shishukaha, Samo, Nada, Meenas, Chilichimaha, Proshti to Shapari Dvayoho, Shudranda Matsya Sanghataha, Potadhan, Rohito, Madguraha, Shalaha, Rajivaha, Shakulas Timihi, Timingiladayascha. These are all the different types of fish. As I don't have much time, I am just, I could only read out these things. And one thing I can talk about, that Timihi is a big, very big fish. Timihi. Timingilaha is a fish which eats timihi. And timingila gila gilaha, that gila gila shabda should be taken for a longer and bigger fish. That is the thing. Atha yadamsi. Yadamsi jalajantavaha. The other jalajantus that you see in water. Shishumaraha udraha. Shishumarodra shankavaha makaradayaha. So Shishumaraha udraha shankuhu makaraha. Again, makaraha is a whale. And kuliraha karkataka. You know, karkataka rasi, nandu. And then we have kumbe kamata kachapau. Kamata kachapau. These are all the tortoise. Kurmaha, kamataha, kachapaha. Grahaha, avaharaha refers to the crocodiles. And then nakrastu kumbhiraha. So grahaha, avaharaha is grahaha means that which catches you. Avaharaha, that which swallows you. That's the difference. But both of them refer to the crocodile family. And we have the Nakrastu Kumbhiraha is a very large crocodile. Is called the Nakra and Kumbhira. And Amara, he talks about Mahilata Gandupataha Kinchulakaha. These are all some Jalajantus which have several legs. And they simply move inside the water. And Nihaka Godhika Same. These are all again another a kind of Godhika. When it is found on the ground, on the bhumi. Godhika is called Udumbu. I don't know what it is called in it is in English. It is called Udumbu. And because its skin is so tough, so strong. In those days, the soldiers used to wear the skin of that Godhika as an armor, and the skin of its legs for protecting the fingers. They used to wear it. So the same kind of the very thick-skinned fish are also called as Nihaka and Godhika. Nihaka and Godhika. And Raktapatu Jalukayam Striyam Bhumi Jalaukasaha. And all these things, they talk about Raktapa means bloodsucker.
It is called monitor lizard. It is called monitor lizard in English.
Oh, I see. Jaluka. Jaluka is our, what is it called in English? In Tamil, it is called Atta. Our Lord Dhanvantari, in one hand, he is holding the Amrita Kalasha. And another hand, he is having Jaluka.
Leech.
In Ayurveda, we have leech therapy. So wherever the blood has gone poisoned, they used to put the leech on the skin. The leech will suck the poison. And you know what they will do? They will give thumb pressure on the leech later on after removing the leech from the particular skin. They will remove the blood out of that jaluka also, because they will have to use it again for the next patient. If it eats the blood, it will also die. So that is the jaloka. And then Mukta Spotaha, again, he talks about the shells, the conscious, Shankaha Syat Kambu Astriyo. And then he talks about the Bheka, Manduka, the frogs, the toads, Shili, Gandubari, Bheki. Shili, Gandubari, Bheki, refers to toad, Kamati, the female and tortoise, Dulihi, Madgurasya Priya Sengi. He even talks about a particular type of fish which has horns, Sringa. Durnama Dirghakoshika, These are all again the leeches which are found in water. And then jalashayo jaladharaha. So it's all about the storage of water. Aha vastu nipanam syat upakupa jalashaye. Yes, these things are. Talk about kasaraha. Kasaraha, big pond. And then with regard to the ponds, he says, akhatam deva khatakam. Akhatam means some kind of a very big pond. Yeah, just a minute. And deva khatakam, the ponds that you see, the ponds which are dug inside the temples, they are called the deva khatakam. And then alavalam, avalam, the tree basins, Ganga, Vishnupadi, and then he talks about the names of several rivers, Reva, Kalindi, Yamuna, Karatoya. Karatoya is, there is a river, it's called Karatoya. In Madurai, we know Vaigai. Vaigai is where the Lord Shankara, he just put his hand and the water flowed from him. So that is why.
Meeting attend pannirukken. I am fine. Vipa, no, professor.
These are all some of these rivers. Shatadru, Shutudri, Vipasha. All these rivers are found in Rig Veda. Okay. Saravati, Vetravati, Chandrabhaga, Kaveri. All these rivers are very popular. And then I think I'll have to stop here as I have lost. I think I have run out of time. And at the outset, I thank Dr. Ananta Narayanan for giving me this opportunity to go through this Amarakosha, because I had a very long time back, nearly some 50 years or 55 years back, I had the chance of having a chandas, repeating it. After being said by our teacher twice. So, from the bottom of my heart, I thank Ananta Narayanan for giving me the opportunity to go through it again, because we have seen the quotations of Amarakosha, quotations of Vaidyayanti Kosha, Haima, and several other lexicons while studying various vyakhyanas for dramas and mahakavyas. But this is the first time ever that I went through the whole of the Varivarga, and I could see the brilliance of Amara in bringing out almost all the words that are connected with water. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Kumaraswamy.